Hi everyone, welcome back to the neighborhood. I've got the KZ EDX in the house for review today. Lately, KZ has been a bit of a mixed bag. Some of it has been great, some of it has been unique, and some of it has been mediocre, and others have been, well, if you watch the channel and follow the blog with regularity, then you'd know. So what's the verdict on this $10 earphone? At that price, can it even be any good? Let's get into it. So the build of this KZ is pretty interesting to me, at least in consideration of its price. The shell here is probably plastic, as there is a clear variant online, but it almost seems as if it's metal. I actually mistook it for metal at first, as it appears to be an enameled, tin-like material. So, something like an old-school lunchbox. But like I've said, it is probably plastic. This is a pretty traditional shell style, akin to the KZ ZSTX, and it fits in my ear most comfortably. The angle is good, and there is a lip on the nozzle to hold your tips in place. The included tips here are clear KZ Starline tips, which is a nicer touch for a $10 IEM from KZ. The cable is also similar to the ZSTX, and it has the same recessed box-style 2-pin connector, inline microphone, and an angled 3.5 termination as that cable does. This time, however, the color is a bright, rose gold colored copper in a traditional KZ weave. It is a bit stiffer than the KZ ZSTX cable, but it isn't as bad as the KZ cables of yesteryear. The sound of the EDX is pretty distinctive, and it actually surprised me, especially given other descriptions of this earphone that I came across prior to this review. I had expected a bassy, mediocre presentation, but instead, I heard something pretty unique. The best way to describe these is that they sound like auto-tune with an underglow of sub-bass warmth. Timbre quality is like that of plate reverb, so these aren't really an accurate or critical listening set, and they're more of an idiosyncratic experience. I do enjoy these though, and I find them to be quite fun, especially given their low price of $10. Auditorily, the low end here is driven by the low bass. It isn't particularly tight, and it has a soft pillow-like quality to it with mild impact and dynamics, never overpowering the rest of the mix. Lower mids are less present than mid and upper components of the mid-range, but even on guitar-driven music, this has a surprising amount of presence throughout most of the mid-range, and I enjoyed them on both classical guitar arrangements and hair metal from the 1980s. Treble wasn't exactly relaxed due to its mildly airy and ambient nature, but it was also somewhat soft in its delivery. There is also some mild thinness to be aware of, but I like the amount of extension here, and I never found things to get harsh, strident, sibilant, or incohesive in their presentation. For its price, I was amazed by its detailing in general, including its peripheral detail, decay, separation, and imaging capabilities. This set can easily keep up with others beyond three times its price in this regard. I also have the CCA CST in the house for review, which has recently been hyped by others, and compared to that set, I find the EDX to be much more capable. I also just reviewed the Tin Hi-Fi T1 Plus as well, and while those have a more accurate tonality, I enjoyed the EDX much more and find its resolution to be a step above both it and the CST. Vocals come across as though they are being captured by a slightly hot mic, but they are easily differentiated from the mix in the case of both male and female singers. There is a slight bright, haunting, and arid quality expressed in the case of most vocalists, but I rarely found this displeasing outside of poorly recorded tracks. So for $10, I really liked this earphone, and I think that you get a lot for your money here, both in terms of build and in terms of sound. The sound is also pretty different here from what other offerings have been in the price range so far, including those by KZ and others alike. Given its price range and distinctive presentation, what's not to love for $10? Just expect a fun and unique presentation rather than an accurate one, and you'll be fine. But before I go, I wanted to say thanks to Dave, the Honest Audiophile, for sending in the EDX for review. So make sure to hit subscribe here, and if you haven't already, check out his channel and his take on the EDX and others as well. You can also become part of my neighborhood by following the blog at intuitreviews.com, following the Twitter, the Instagram, joining the Discord, or by becoming a Patreon. The Patreon is only $1.50 a month, and it shows your support to the channel and gets you access to early written reviews from me. And as always, thanks for watching. I really appreciate you all. And with that, I'm out for now.